Hello.
Hello, good morning.
Good morning. You're all dressed up. Are we going out somewhere?
Yeah, after session, I'll go for shopping.
Wow. What are you going to shop for? Anything in particular?
Not particular, means I am looking for some clothes. So I'll go for that.
Nice. So luckily, today's topic is financial literacy and financial management.
I don't think so, but I'm okay with that because I already have talked yesterday. Yes.
On this?
Yes. But I am okay with that.
So we can talk about the next topic then, outer space.
Yeah. Yes.
All right, awesome. So the topic is outer space or deep ocean. Okay. Wait, did you take another session after mine yesterday?
Yes.
Oh,
I
yeah,
had
this is why we get confused because I thought this was your next session.
it happens always.
Yeah, because after bucket list, financial literacy was there.
Yeah.
But it's surprising that you spoke about financial literacy yesterday and now you're going shopping. Suspicious. I think you realize you have too much money. That's why you're like, I think I should go
No.
shopping and spend.
No, I am not that kind of person who go frequently for shopping.
Goes frequently for shopping.
Yes, I go. Sorry?
I'm not the kind of person who goes frequently.
Okay, who goes?
Yes.
Yes, I do shopping when I have some requirement.
All right, cool. So should we move on to the topic then?
Okay.
Today we have an extempore.
Yes.
Rural development or why is humor an important life skill?
Okay.
Which one would you
So,
like to choose?
you just suggest me. I cannot say that which topic I should take.
Why is humor
Then.
an important life skill?
Okay. Humor is, should be an important life skill for everyone because humor is something that needs nowadays. Means life is so fast, we are running through our works, we are facing stress, depression, and all kind of these kind of things. So one should be have this skill, I think so, and it is also beneficial for health, our health. It secretes some good hormones in our body when you feel laugh or when you feel happy. So I think so that is a significant life skill, and everybody should possess this skill.
Yes. Everybody just suggest this kid.
Possess, third tense,
Possess. Okay.
possess, yeah.
No,
But what
I'm
is the
not possessive.
pronunciation?
Possess.
Possess.
Possess, yes.
Possess. Yeah.
Okay. So, okay, we'll move on to the next topic, but there are two mistakes that you made over here. Okay.
Okay.
Humor is a skill that everybody needs. You said that needs nowadays. That needs nowadays. I think what you were trying to say is that everybody needs nowadays. Okay. Second
Okay.
mistake was one should be have this skill. Do you know
Yes.
what the mistake is in that sentence? One should be have this skill.
One should have. There is no need to be put B.
You just put an extra B in this correction sentence. There is no need to be put B. There is
Yes.
no need to put B.
There is no need to put B.
B, exactly.
Okay.
So now that I've corrected your correction, we move
Okay.
on to the topic. Oh, by the way, you also said secrete incorrectly.
Secrets. I don't know exactly what is the pronunciation.
Secrete. Reet.
Secrete. Reet.
Yes.
Secrete.
Yes.
Okay.
the human body secretes hormones when experiencing humor or something that makes you laugh.
Okay. Secrete. Okay.
Yeah, dopamine is the chemical in our brains that triggers a happy emotion.
Yes.
Right. Nowadays, we get it when we use Instagram. Every time we scroll, we get a dopamine rush. Every time we get a like, we get a dopamine rush.
Okay.
Some people who drink or smoke, they do that for the dopamine, right? So that is the chemical you're looking for, dopamine.
Yes, yes, dopamine. And there is also a hormone, I don't know the name, bad hormones.
Serotonin? Cortisol.
Yes, I don't know exactly. Serotonin
is also good. Serotonin is also, I mean, it's not good, but it's feel good. Okay. Stress hormones will be cortisol, right? What else is there in that oil ad? They say, na, cholesterol is bad.
Okay.
Okay. I don't know what else is there. Okay. So, Megha.
Yes.
Outer space or deep ocean?
If you ask me which...
Which one do you prefer? Outer space. Deep ocean.
I would. You ask me where you want to go or which would you prefer?
Which one would you prefer? And then I'll ask you where would you like to go.
Okay. So if I have to choose between these, I would choose deep ocean.
Wow. You are that exception. 90% of people choose outer space.
Okay. There is a reason, because if I would choose that, so there will be a chance that I would not return back.
This is same with ocean, you know.
No, but I am confident that I know swimming.
Wow.
To do swimming.
You know, deep ocean is like really deep. You can't just swim up like that.
Yeah, I know that. But at least I know swimming. So I have some confidence that there is a chance if I go into deep ocean, so I can survive over there. I feel so. I take it in this way.
Okay. Before you can swim up to the surface, by the way, your suit can fail, you can run out of oxygen, you can get hurt with some sort of rocks, you can get hurt from the animals, you can get eaten by a shark.
Yes.
You can, by the way, deep ocean is so deep that you don't even see the light, so you don't know which direction to swim in. You could be swimming a lot and going deeper.
Yeah, but if we talk in this way, so in this perspective, means we can save our life. You know, but if you want to explore the deep ocean, you want to explore all the things, what are the things inside of ocean. So in that way also, I would prefer to go deep ocean.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay. You're a hopeful person. I like that. Okay. That's nice. Positivity. Awesome.
Thank you.
So what would you like to see when you explore the deep ocean?
I just want to know, because I heard that thing that so far only 5% of ocean is explored. So I just want to know what is rest of 95%. Is there any new animals or some strange kind of thing, something which makes me intrigued. This is new word I'm trying to use.
Intrigued.
Intrigued.
Go. Yes.
Intrigued.
Yes.
Yes. So I just want to explore what, like, you know, this is like Samudra Manthan kind of things. Kya kya niklega andar se? So I just want to know that.
So we have explored more of space than we have of something in our own planet, which is the deep ocean. Because the technology is very limited. And even though there is technology to explore all of the ocean, it's too expensive.
Okay. Right?
Plus, we don't know what's down there.
Okay.
I'm sorry. I didn't sleep well last night. I'm so sorry. I wasn't feeling well. So, you are right. I would have chosen the same option so that I can explore something and my name can be in the world forever. You know, Divyam explored this species. He discovered this species. I want that as well.
Even if you survive, that would be great. And if you couldn't survive, even it would be great. Right?
Why do you say that? Why would it be great if I don't survive?
Because as you mentioned, your name will be...
Oh, after discovering something?
Yes. At least you will be the first person who went there, who would go...
No, so I won't be the first person. I'm sure all of the ocean... Actually, I don't know anything about that. You're right. I could be the first person.
Yes. That is very...
That is an achievement in itself.
Yes, that is an achievement for you and me. If we can do that,
yeah,
but
that's
for
true.
But for that, I think we need too much courage. It's easy to speak, but whenever you will get the chance to go, would you prefer to go there if you will get the chance?
No, because I'm scared of depths. I can't handle that. I have a fear of depth and height, both. So it's a very weird story. I've always been scared of deep waters. Okay, ever since my father taught me how to swim. I would never wear goggles when I'm swimming because I can't see inside the pool. So I have that ignorant brain. It's okay, it's not that deep, it's not that deep, it's not that deep. And I would swim in the deep end. Okay, I will swim in the deep end.
Okay.
But I can never look in the pool. Like, it scares me. And I promised myself that I will get over it. And to do that, I started a pool business.
Okay.
I started it. I joined someone who was in the pool industry. And for about 9 months, 9 months, I worked in a pool industry where I was in a company where we constructed pools. We cleaned pools. We provided pool accessories. So now in my brain...
You surrounded yourself...
With my fear.
Yes.
Yes. So I used to have this fear that, you know, if I put my... Like, my leg is going to get stuck in the fan of the... You know, like on the sides there are lights and stuff.
Okay. Right? Okay. Yes.
As a kid, I always thought that because when I was a kid, I cut myself on one of those things.
Okay.
Right, on the light, because the tile was, I think, broken. So I must have cut myself. And since then, I was like, oh my God, all these holes in the walls have fans in it.
Okay.
For compensation. So I would always be scared of those lights and I would always be scared of the depth. But then, like, obviously, I grew older and I'm like, that's stupid. But then your brain still doesn't understand the fear part, right? So even when I would swim, I would be like, it's fine, it's just light. But then I would still like try to keep my legs away from it. Okay. And then I'm like, leave this. I'm going to start like this thing. I'm going to move to a city and I'm going to do this. And I did it for 6-9 months. Then I came back to Mumbai.
All right. That's great. Next story. <Yeah. laughs>
So now I know everything about pools, like how the filtration works, how the water is so, so dirty.
Okay.
And since I stopped working in that pool business, I have not gone swimming even once.
Because do you ever swim into pond?
No, I can't do that. Yeah, I can't do that. I can't swim anywhere where I don't know everything about the place.
Oh my God.
Yeah. So I was only swimming in my own client's pools. The ones I was, like, not I physically, but the ones that my company was cleaning.
I used to do that in my childhood. And I can say I'm very good in it, means swimming into pond, but couple of years ago I did river rafting and I was so confident that I can swim anywhere, and the trainer told me that there is water is calm, plain, you can go jump into the river, and I jumped. That I knew swimming, so I can survive easily, but I couldn't hold a single second because swimming in river is completely different thing.
Yes. But the current jumped, is too strong.
Yes, I jumped and I was crying. And suddenly he came and pulled me off.
He pulled me onto the boat.
Yes, onto the boat.
Onto the raft, I guess.
Yes. So I came to know that swimming in pond is different and swimming in river is completely different. You cannot include both things.
Yes. The pond water is stagnant. It doesn't move, right? So there's no current in it.
There's no
flow.
When
it comes to river rafting, because of the geographical situation, the currents are really strong sometimes. On turns and on the drops.
Yes. When I think about that, I feel that how can I do that? How could I do that? Is it correct to say?
Yes. How I could do it.
How I could do it, yes. I was so confident on that time, but I understand. Time. Yeah. Sorry?
You were so confident at that time.
Okay. I was so confident at that time. Okay.
See, Megha, you're speaking so well. You have good content. You have good context about what to say, how to move a conversation forward, okay? But you're making mistakes in prepositions. Be, to, at. All of these
into,
things.
Into, onto, yes.
Yes, into, onto. These are things that you are, you may know the information, but in your head, when it's going from your head to your mouth, that filter, I don't know why it's not filtering. You know, and your brain says, "Nay, nay, this is wrong. We have to fix it."
Right? Is there any specific practice to remove these things?
We have 30 seconds left. I can't tell you right now. But I'll put it in the feedback. Whoever takes the next session will let you know how to do it. Okay?
Okay. All right.
All right. Megha, it was nice talking to you. You look really nice today. Good luck with your shopping. And hopefully you find some good deals.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
Right. You're welcome. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.